Hi, I'm Vince, also known as Pleasant Kenobi on the internet, and today I want to talk about something that's been bothering me a little bit about Crimson Vow. The set is going by with not much of a bang in any format, and that's not my main complaint. I'm just trying to understand why I feel so unenthused about it. I'm kind of bored of it already, and it feels a little bit cheap, is another feeling I've got. Perhaps I'm too used to standard sets dominating Modern and Legacy, reinvigorating or absolutely wrecking, depending on how you look at it, each of those formats, all the older formats, with new power creep design that has no right to exist in the game of Magic the Gathering. So it's nice to be powered down. I think powered down is a good thing from time to time. That's not my main complaint, but it might factor into this feeling I've got. I then thought perhaps it's the wedding thing. I thought when it was announced that a wedding, like a novelty vampire wedding, wasn't my cup of tea. I enjoy a good wedding. I like getting very drunk with my friends and family, but I'm not that excited by the idea of weddings as a concept, nor as a gimmick for a Magic the Gathering card game trading card game set. But with that said, the world building, the art direction, the wonderful artistry of the artists that work on Magic the Gathering has actually made me care more about it than I thought it would. That trailer as well. I end up thinking that the Crimson Vow, the wedding, was more exciting than I thought it would be. But I still couldn't put my finger on what it is about the set that was putting me off. Until a friend of mine was talking about the set with me, it's Brian, the professor of Tolarian Community College. We were talking on a podcast episode, actually, that will be coming out in the future of this video, probably. So here's a hint, a teaser for something in the future, about how the set seems very on the nose. It feels very ham-fisted about its central conceit, its central gimmick, the vampire wedding. Wedding announcement, bridal gown or bride's gown, and wedding ring are probably the biggest culprits in being the most straight up simplistic cards in terms of their theming. They're so on the nose that they almost give me a nosebleed. None of these are big, nor are they clever. None of them involve you having to do even a minimal amount of work or thinking to understand the reference. Sometimes with Magic cards, you have like a eureka moment where someone explains part of the plot or a reference to another thing or an actual just a real world or cultural or pop culture reference, and you kind of get it twigs, and you're like, huh, right, that makes more sense. But these are so just like, here they are. And these have existed in Magic before. We've had like bronze sword and long bow and things like that. But they're normally like small placeholdery things that they aren't world building. Well, these kind of feel like they're part of the world building and they feel simplistic at the same time, which kind of makes it feel like the central gimmick is kind of simple. In some ways, I wonder if these were developmental names, right? They were names that were thought up early in R&D and somehow got to the end stages and into the final product. Things that were going to get changed, like Olivia's Wedding Band or Crimson Circle or something that is more thematically on point than just wedding ring. Think of it this way. We got wedding ring, we got wedding invitation, we got all these things that are very on the nose. We never had Samurai's Helmet in Kamigawa. We never had King's Crown in Throne of Eldraine. We never had things that were so on the nose. And come to think of it, Throne of Eldraine was often criticized for having really ham-fisted references. And this ran a little bit too as well with references to The Fly and other horror tropes. Those things had very explicit references that people mocked, but nothing was overtly this simplistic. And the thing is, gimmicks are part of Magic. Like, every set is essentially a gimmick. It is Magic's, like, operating mode. Kamigawa is the Japanese samurai ninja set. Throne of Eldraine is the fairy tale set. Amonkhet is Egyptian. Deros is Greek. There is a common through line with this across all the sets. And Innistrad is not exempt from this. It's the gothic horror set for the most part. And that's normal. But it's not normally as on the nose as this. And part of me wonders if the gimmick, the central idea or concept of weddings, would never have worked on its own, right? No one was going to buy Wedding the set, so it needed Innistrad to hold its hand. And I don't think that's a problem. I'm not saying I'm upset or annoyed about it. I mean, Innistrad can't keep doing the same thing over and over. It can be a place or a home for other ideas or stories to be told or explored, but I just feel that this one was a little bit half-baked. Even that the Planeswalkers are a little bit kind of like this. Sorin the Reluctant Guest is Sorin the Mirthless, and Janna is Dressed to Impress, but only one threat removed with Dressed to Kill, with a pun on her mission at the wedding. Why couldn't Bride's Gown be Olivia's gown? Why couldn't it be Blood Mistress's gown? Or something that just builds the world up a bit more than a very obvious and mundane thing. Two examples that I like that feel more akin to older Magic versions of this is Dying to Serve and Sanguine Statuette. Both of these ones, sort of, they don't immediately tell you exactly what they're doing, but they hint heavily at it, which allows you to unpack it and pick at it a little bit and sort of build up the world in your mind. It is part of Magic's formula to have, instead of Monster of the Week, we have gratuitous pop culture or cultural idea of the week. But the wedding set, it wasn't going to win me around the first time either and end up not winning me around in the end. What a weird set, eh? What a weird set. Maybe I'm being too harsh because this isn't my thing. Maybe you really enjoyed the campy gothic horror cum vampire wedding thing. Let me know in the comment section below if you think I'm being too harsh. I've been Vince, also known as Pleasant Kenobi on the internet. You can check out more of my content, which is whimsical like this, as well as gameplay and more scathing criticism of the game over on my channel on youtube.com/Pleasant Kenobi. In the meantime, be good to one another, and I'll see you all soon. Ta-ta for now.